Good afternoon and welcome to Deshdoot Kids Katha. This is a special segment where we get to hear what kids want to say, what are their opinions, and how do they perceive the things that are happening around them. So with every segment, we bring to you a special civic sense topic. Today we are here at Wisdom High International School, and I would like to start by introducing our today's panel. Can you guys please introduce yourself, your name, your age, and of course your hobbies.
My name is Trishal Modi. I'm in class 7A. My age is 12 and a half. And my hobbies are to play basketball, cricket, and also I like to read any type of books.
My name is Nipun Beche. I'm from grade 7B. I'm 12.5 years old. And my hobbies are kind of playing any game you want to play with me.
My name is Jean Kerman. I'm from 6C. My hobby is to play football.
My name is Vainavi Panita. I'm from 7th A. I'm 12 years old and my hobby is to play chess.
My name is Pranada Wani. I am from 7E. My age is 12 and a half years. And my hobby is like spending time in the lap of nature.
My name is Meena Shah. I am from grade 7D. My hobby is to play karate.
So, what comes to your mind when you hear the word civic sense? Anybody, you guys can also answer if you want. What is civic sense?
You think about the laws and constitution of a country.
To think about laws and constitution of a country, okay.
Politics.
Politics, okay. Anybody from the audience? Yeah?
To think about civics.
There's no need to laugh, he's crying. To have information, what is right. So basically, civic sense is the do's and don'ts that you follow in your public life. What are the do's and don'ts you follow in your public life? You're walking on the road.
First of all, we follow the signal. On green light, we go, and on red light, we stop.
Okay.
We should always walk on the zebra crossing while they are crossing the road. We should always wear a helmet while they are riding bikes or scooters.
Okay. And what else? Anybody from here? Yeah.
You should always wear seatbelts while driving cars.
Okay, those are driving rules that we follow. Other rules? Others?
When we are in we should respect everyone in the public. We should try to be kind and polite to all the people of the country, as we know we are all are equal in our country. There should be no discrimination about anyone.
We should keep the cleanliness around our surroundings.
Some of the bullying are happening, like men are bullying women and something like that, or children also. So that should not happen, because it's also a part of our laws or rules.
You should have a decent behavior, and you should behave properly with everybody. Okay. So, yes.
Ma'am, we should not tease anyone or anybody. It's like you're fat, you're thin, you're dark, like this.
Body shaping. Okay. So today's topic
should not be racist.
We should not be racist. I'm glad. Okay. So today's topic is actually pollution. So just take 1 or 2 seconds, close your eyes. When you hear the word, what comes to your mind? What picture forms in front of your mind? Close your eyes for 1 to 2 seconds. Okay? Can you describe the picture for me?
Ma'am, we can just see the smoke coming from the factories. The people are throwing the garbage in the rivers.
So you see smoke coming from the factories, people are throwing garbage.
A dirty river full of pollution because of factories throwing their waste in the river. Okay. The outlets in the river. I just want to share one of my experience that there's a river beside our house. It's been dirtied and polluted. So worst condition of it is till last year no stink of that river came to our house because we live in the but this year it's quite stinky and we feel like very uneasy.
Yeah. So that picture comes to your mind when you hear the word pollution. Okay.
Even I would like to tell my experience. I went in Kolkata just 3-4 months ago and what happened, we were in a houseboat, so we were going on the other side of the city. So what I saw, a man was drinking cold drink. So there was dustbin just beside him, but he threw the cold drink bottle in the river.
Sad.
But
you didn't stop it?
I was going to tell him, but I himmat nahi thi.
Fine, that's fine. At least you thought that you could, that is wrong. Yeah, that is the first step.
Our river goddess Ganga is also not polluted due to.
Yeah, I agree.
When we hear the word pollution, like two pictures come in front of our mind. Oh, one is very clean, the roads are very clean, there is not a single nothing of pollution. And on the other side, like every type of pollution is being seen. The factory, the smoke from factories, plastic bags in the rivers, and all the cold drink cans and everything on the roadside, which can be the reason for some of the accidents also.
Okay. You have
When we say about pollution, it is that after some year it would not be easy for us to live.
Okay. Since you said after some years it would not be easy for us to live, I have a question. Does anybody know Greta Thunberg? Greta Thunberg.
Greta Thunberg. She's a young girl and she's spreading awareness about global warming and how a country's been submerged after some years.
Is there a special campaign that she has started? There is.
I've heard in the newspaper that she has started a campaign. She's very young and spreading awareness to stop pollution. So she started a campaign called No School Friday, where all school students come on the road and protest for pollution. And it is a great success. She's been speaking at various international organizations, UN and many more. So go look on YouTube once for Greta Thunberg. Okay, so I'd like to move ahead.
I'd like to share one more thing which came to my mind when I just thought about the word of word pollution. Just a world where there is no oxygen present in the atmosphere and you're in your house with a purifier, air purifier, and when you want to go to school, you just can't go because you don't have an oxygen mask.
That might be a reality after some years. So, what is the definition of pollution, like a scientific definition? Since we all learn it in school, like this, it is there everywhere.
What the proper usage of things.
Or
contamination of our environment.
Contamination of our environment. Okay. So what kinds of pollution? What are the types of pollution that you know?
Water pollution, air pollution, land pollution and sound pollution.
Okay. So can somebody tell me what is water pollution?
As I gave the example, the river, it's dirty because of the waste that are thrown out of factory outlets into rivers. They get dirty and there is shortage of drinking water and all water gets contaminated.
And what are the effects of water pollution? I mean, what do you see? What happens to us? What happens to the nature?
We do not get clean water.
Sometimes we get contaminated water which is not good for health. It may lead to diseases like cholera.
And the organisms which live in the water, they can start strikes. It's difficult for them to survive because of dirty water.
Why is it difficult for them to survive because of the
For example, if we take fishes, we throw all of them throw plastic things in the water, and they do not have smart brains like us, so they don't know that what should they eat and what they should not eat. So when they eat those things, their throat starts choking because that gets stuck into their throat.
Right.
So they start. It's difficult for them to survive.
Sea turtles population is depleting.
Yes.
Because they simply eat the plastic waste in the ocean and they just die because of choking throat.
Do you know which is the famous, very famous known type of turtles on the west coast of India?
Greenback turtles.
Or else olive ridley turtles? So recently the Versova beach was cleaned. And it took almost 6 to 7 months to clean that beach, and still it is not clean. But for years and years, the olive ridley turtles, they used to hatch their eggs there. But they had stopped doing it because of the uncleanliness and everything. And since the beach was clean, they have started coming back, and you can see them these days on Versova beach, which is in Mumbai. Okay, and do only industrial byproducts, only those cause water pollution, or is there anything else?
Yes. The only thing is not that water pollution is affected by industrial waste, but people also wash their clothes. So all the germs on the clothes or the animals get reduced to the water. So that's why that is also an effect.
So do we know that we throw flowers in the river, thinking that flowers are biodegradable? Nirmanya, all of us have it after Ganpati. We throw it. What happens of that?
They just go down in the water, settle there, and some later it becomes humus.
It is the amount of flowers that we throw in the water is very difficult for our rivers. It is not very easy for them to biodegrade so easily. So the thing is, there is a organization in, I don't know exactly the place, but it is an organization which is aimed to clean the Ganga River. So basically all the Nirmalya that goes into the river is actually collected in the temple itself before it is thrown into the river, and it is processed, and out of that they make incense sticks and all such things. That is Phool. The name of the organization is Phool. You can look them up on the internet as well. It's a very good organization and a very good thought behind it. Okay, and what more is water pollution? What causes it?
The sewage waste that are thrown out by the government in some rivers which are supposed to be clean some 15 to 20 years ago. Nandini?
Yes.
That river, my mom told me that it was quite clean when we came to Nasik earlier.
Which river is actually Nandini?
Ma'am, we call it Nasir.
Exactly.
Yes, because earlier it was a river, we kept polluting it and the sewage waste was continuously thrown there, and now it's become a nala.
Okay. So what can we do from our side to reduce water pollution?
We should not throw waste in water and we should not throw waste in the water. The industrial people who work in the factories should also not put the waste in the water. People should not wash their clothes and animals in the water.
We should have outlets which not go in the river. They should went for purification and then should be left in the river.
Okay.
I expect the government to work over this. They have made laws but they are not properly executed. But I expect the government to take some measures so that the industries do not pollute, because a major part of water pollution comes because of industries.
Okay. And so that is what we can do to reduce water pollution. So what else can we do from our side? Not as a government, not as a society, just one side. What can we do?
Ma'am, for water pollution, the outlets which are being put into the rivers can be put out somewhere else which can be useful. And on the other side, the thing which I told about plastic bags and all that, we've made the wet dustbin, dustbins. We've divided it, but it's not it is not being used. It's not being used properly.
It's not being followed. The government has made all the procedures, but we are not following them. That's what they said. So we must follow all the procedures the government has already told us, and we must adhere to the rules that the society has given us and try to reduce water pollution as much as possible from our side. Do not throw garbage, do not do such things that will help pollute the water. If you see somebody doing it, have courage and tell them to not do it, okay? So I would like to give the mic to my colleague.
First of all, I would like to know how many of y'all read the newspaper every day. Honest answers, come on. Only these many. That's it. Okay. So now let's have a rapid fire session where I would test your GPA, that how much do you know about the city you live in. Okay, and the boys there, you guys have been talking a lot. Please, you're being recorded. Please maintain silence. Okay?
Okay.
My first question would be, the father of Indian cinema belongs to our city. Who is he? Good. Let's give him a round of applause. After how many years is the Kumbh Mela held in Nashik? Okay, we have a break. Okay. Coldest temperature recorded in Nashik this year.
Thank you so much for the panel. And as we know, Deshdoot has its golden jubilee year this year. So they have announced a competition of a video making competition. You have to make a 50 seconds video on Civic Sense. You can do it on your phone. The prizes are up to 50,000 rupees. And the winners have a contract with ZTV. So if you guys are interested, please send them your videos on the email. You can get them on the emails, you can get on Google. Okay? Thank you so much.